trying to choke out your potential. And don't get it twisted just because you're walking around. A lot of people walking around, they're spiritually dead. And I'd rather be spiritually alive than physically dead. Come on, just somebody. Because at least if you're physically dead, you could be with the Lord. But if you're spiritually dead, that means you ain't got no God on the inside of you. And so the enemy wants us to get it twisted and confused. Amen, somebody. But I started notice today, you will live both spiritually and physically, and so will I. Can I get a witness in here right now? The enemy wants to choke out your potential with all that's going on, but we would not live in fear. God hasn't given us the spirit of fear, but of power, of love, and a sound of mind. Now educate me. Talk to me. Let me know. Tell me what's expected of me. Amen. Paul said in verse 8, can we put verse 8 up there, that there is trouble on every side. Some of you brothers feel me in here right now, that's been to court here and out of the court system. You know what it's like when you are troubled on every side. Paul said, we are afflicted in every way. And King James says we are troubled on every side. How many of you know you can handle just a little bit of trouble? How many of you know you can handle one trouble in your life? Even the enemy knows you can handle one or two troubles. I mean, if you just got that car trouble, come on. You get somebody to pick you up. That's all you got. Deal with chip nail, fingernail, chip, need a pill in. Come on. That ain't no real trouble right there. That's not no real trouble right there. He knows that you can have, amen, car trouble and even be into it with your spouse. He knows that. Amen. But he knows this. Don't forget this. We are not built to handle trouble on every side. I wish I had somebody here right now. So when we start feeling trouble on every side, something eventually got to hit. When you start having trouble at home, trouble on the job, come on, sickness in your body, trouble with your children, trouble in your relationship, not enough money to pay your bills, how do you know? The devil knows it's a matter of time that something got to hit. Well, it's the same thing in your life, that's the same thing that happened in Brother Eric Gordon's life the other day. He was troubled on every side. And all of this coming at him at one time, something had to give. But I got good news for you today. No matter what people take away from you, they can't take away your praise. I need somebody right now to make a decision that no matter what you go through, you still gonna be found giving God a praise. Paul says we are troubled on every side, but we're not distressed. We are perplexed, but we're not in despair. Paul is telling us with all that we got going on, still have not been destroyed. And some of you right now, the enemy don't even know how you still alive. Sure, I don't even know how you still alive. You ought to get up and give God a praise right now and tell your neighbor, God has kept me alive. Look at your neighbor, your neighbor, one thing I got, I still got a praise down on the inside. Look at another neighbor and say, neighbor, one thing I got,
the blood. What
man that got killed in Ferguson and his blood ran out on the street where he might have been dead, but the life wasn't in his body, but the life was in the blood. Tell your neighbor, the neighbor, even when you die, the blood, it still got power. Where did you get it from, Pastor Steve? I read in my Bible that Cain killed his brother Abel. But the Bible says that when Abel, when his blood left out of his body and ran out of the ground, Cain tried to hide, and God said, Cain, what have you done? Have you killed your brother? And Cain said, how did you know? God said, because his blood is tied up to me. Tell your neighbor, the neighbor, the life is in the blood. You got a loved one that's going to be with the Lord. You ought to give God praise because the life was in the blood. That's why I'm glad that we can be saved like I told you Wednesday night. Jesus came during the Easter season that we could be saved. I'm going to talk to y'all for just a few moments. I'm so glad that God didn't make us like the angels, because when he made the angels, the Bible said the angels, they are ministering spirits. In other words, they do minister to the saints. In other words, when the angels were created, they were created a little lower than the humans. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, thank God you're not an angel. Because when Lucifer fell, he took a third of the angels with him. But the Bible says that when the angel fell, God didn't give them no plan to be redeemed. I would have church all by myself. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, but when man fell, God said, Jesus, he said, Jesus, one day man gonna fall. And the only way I can redeem them, I got to have some blood. I wish I had somebody. Angels don't have no blood. So Jesus said, okay, daddy, prepare me a body. So he stripped off divinity, slipped in humanity, and came down and walked the earth for 33 years. Why did he do it? So that he could not be called an illegal alien. See, the devil is an illegal alien. He should have been born of a woman. He should have had blood in his body. But he's an illegal alien. So tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, that's the whole reason that the angels can